Cashback cards with rotating bonus categories are a great way to easily earn points and cash back, especially on things that you would normally purchase in your daily life. They do require a bit more work to remember the categories every quarter. However, the rewards are worth the effort. Hey, how's it going, everyone? It's Ernest from Trip Astute. In this video, we're covering the 2020 third quarter bonus categories for the Chase Freedom, Discover It, US Bank Cash Plus, and Citi Dividend card, and sharing some free tools that you can use to help you remember the new categories. First off, I know this is a challenging and anxious time for many of you because of the pandemic. Our normal lives have been disrupted and will likely continue to be different until things settle down. I know a lot of you have been affected by the situation in a variety of ways, whether it's your own health or those of your loved ones, your business, or even your travel plans. I encourage you all to stay safe. And if you have any questions or need advice on travel, we're here to help in any way possible. Since we're quickly approaching quarter three, I wanted to make sure to review our new rotating bonus categories for some of our favorite cashback cards. Also, as always, I've got some free tools on our website that you can use to help you remember the new bonus categories. For the Chase Freedom card, we're ending the second quarter bonus categories of gym memberships, fitness clubs, grocery stores, and streaming services. Starting this quarter, you'll earn 5% on Amazon.com and Whole Foods purchases. I'm very excited about getting 5% on Amazon purchases. With the pandemic, we've been purchasing a lot more online, especially on Amazon. Also, since I had the Amazon bonus category on my Citi Dividend card this past quarter, I find that I was still earning a bonus on Amazon Pay purchases on other sites. For example, I purchased a baby bassinet and some other items outside of Amazon, but using the Amazon Pay option. These purchases all counted toward the bonus. It's possible that Chase will treat these purchases differently, so I'll have to do some testing to find out. However, my guess is that they will earn the bonus. The Whole Foods category should be useful for many of you as well, though keep in mind that Amazon offers multiple grocery services outside of Whole Foods, like Amazon Fresh. We've used both Whole Foods and Amazon Fresh the past few months, and it's been a great way to get groceries delivered to our door. The Chase Freedom remains one of my favorite cards. I've had this card since 2012, and I consider it a workhorse in my wallet. It might look like any other 5% rotating bonus card, but if you value Chase Ultimate Reward Points at more than 1 cent, as I do, you'll be earning a lot more value with this card. In fact, I would argue that I earn an adjusted rate of 7.5% with this card, since I value Chase Ultimate Reward Points at 1.5 cents. For more information on how I measure point values and the adjusted earning rates, check out our video on the topic. For the Discover It card, we're ending the second quarter with the bonus categories of gas stations, Uber, Lyft, and wholesale clubs. Starting this quarter, you'll earn 5% on purchases from restaurants and when using PayPal. Like the Chase Freedom card, the bonus is valid for up to $1,500 of qualified spending. The promotional details for the restaurant category says that you'll earn the bonus for restaurants for pickup and deliveries. However, if you look at the fine print, it's unclear whether it includes delivery services that work with restaurants and cafes. Discover says that restaurant purchases include only those made at merchants classified as full-service restaurants, cafes, cafeterias, and fast food locations. To me, this implies that delivery services are excluded. I also called Discover to ask about it, and I got a very ambiguous answer on it. So for practical purposes, I would assume that third-party delivery services are excluded. You'll only earn the bonus for deliveries and pickup orders if you're ordering directly from the restaurant or cafe. I do like the PayPal bonus category though. In the past, I was surprised at how easy it was to maximize the bonus when paying different online retailers using PayPal. Also, if you look at the fine print, it includes PayPal transfers to family and friends. While you'll pay around 3% to do a peer-to-peer transfer via PayPal, you'll still come out ahead since you're getting 5% back. Also, for those of you that pay monthly or quarterly taxes, like I do, you might consider using the Discover card to make the payments as well. Like peer-to-peer transfers, you'll pay a processing fee or percentage, but you should come out ahead with a 5% bonus. For example, as of this video, PayUSA tax charges 1.98% for tax payments using PayPal. So you'll net the 3% difference with the cashback bonus. The Discover It is a solid cashback card. I've had mine since 2009. While I still use it regularly, I still prefer my Chase Freedom. This is mostly due to the fact that I prefer to earn points over cash back. With points, I'm generally able to redeem them for even more value. Though depending on your credit card setup and strategy, you might find more value in earning cash back. For the US Bank Cash Plus card, there are no new categories or changes this quarter. The only thing that is new is that the card has a new look and design. If you're not familiar with the card, US Bank allows you to pick your rotating 5% categories every quarter and also has 2% categories where you can earn unlimited cash back. They even let you earn the 5% bonus on up to $2,000 of spend per quarter on the combined selected bonus categories, which is even better than the Chase Freedom. The card also includes some unique and rare bonus categories like home utilities. In my opinion, it's an underrated credit card and one that can really help capture more bonuses with your everyday spend. Since I try to capture a bonus category on as much of my spending as possible, this card helps me to get closer to that goal. I got this card in 2018 and I've used it as a backup for spending categories that aren't covered by my Chase Freedom or Discover It card. Before the pandemic, I typically selected gyms and home utilities as my two 5% categories every quarter. For this quarter, I'll probably select home utilities and department stores. Lastly, Citi Dividend users are ending the second quarter bonus categories of drugstores and Amazon.com. And for the third quarter of 2020, we'll be receiving 5% at home improvement stores and on popular streaming services. For hardware stores, just be aware that florist supply stores, nursery stock, and flower stores are not eligible for the bonus. However, lawn and garden stores and nurseries do qualify. For streaming services, Citi defines popular streaming services as Amazon Prime Video, CBS All Access, Fubo TV, Netflix, Pandora, Showtime, Sling TV, Spotify, Stars, Vudu, YouTube Premium, and YouTube TV. Unfortunately, Hulu, HBO, and Apple TV seem to be missing from the list. Keep in mind that the Citi Dividend card has a yearly award bonus cap of $300 per calendar year, which means that you're not restricted by a specific quarter's bonus. You can earn all your annual bonus in one quarter. You just need to track how much bonus you earn over the entire calendar year. The Citi Dividend card is not available for new applicants. It used to be available through a product change from another Citi card, but that no longer seems to be the case since late 2019. That may change in the future, but for now, there's no way to get the card. As always, we've put together some free tools that you can download to help you remember these categories. We have our popular wallet size cheat sheet and our smartphone lock screens. I've got a few variations of the lock screen too, in case you only want information for only one of the cards and not the others. It usually takes me a while before the new categories get set in my brain, so if you're like me and you need a little reminder, I'm hoping these tools come in handy. Just head over to our website and click on credit cards and then free credit card tools. I'll include a link in the video description as well. As a reminder, make sure you log in and activate the bonus for these cards. While you can wait until September 14th to activate your Chase Freedom bonus category, since Chase will award the points retroactively, you're better off doing it now before you forget. Unfortunately, Discover, US Bank, and Citi won't award you a bonus until you activate it, so make sure you do it now to avoid missing out. And in case you're interested in applying for any of these cards, I've included a link to our credit card offers page. Any signups that go through our site or link help to support the channel. Since these cards do not have an annual fee, they're a great way to augment your current setup and earn additional cash back or points. As of June 2020, the Chase Freedom and US Bank Cash Plus are offering a welcome offer for new applications. The Chase Freedom also has some new benefits recently added to the card, including a 3-month complimentary membership to Dash Pass, which is DoorDash's subscription service. The card also earns 5% on Lyft rides. And if you're interested, Discover is offering a cashback match for an entire year, so it's fairly lucrative. What do you all think of the new quarterly bonus categories? Are you excited or disappointed by them? Let me know in the comment section below. We hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If so, please give us a thumbs up, subscribe, and consider sharing our video with others. It may not seem like much, but it helps us to grow this channel and community. I hope you all are staying healthy and safe during these crazy times. Until next time, travel safe and travel smart.